Today we're gonna be discussing about 10 things to do when you play Call of Duty Zombies with randoms. And trust me, if you don't play with randoms, after you finish watching this video, hey, you would wanna play with randoms. And whatever you're imagining right now, it's gonna be 10x that. You're gonna have the ultimate fun, I can guarantee. And also, this is gonna be a part one, meaning there are more things to discuss about, and that means that there's gonna be a part two, maybe even part three, four. You get the idea, right? And I feel like having mini-series, basically, for all these 10 things that I've been doing recently, because I've been enjoying making these videos, and it seems like you guys do too. And if you do something when you play with randoms, or want to do, or have seen someone do a savage move, let me know in the comments, and I may feature you in my next video. But speaking of that, these are some of the new homies that actually subscribe to the channel, and a massive shout out to all of them and everyone else. If you're new to the channel, hey, make sure to subscribe with notifications for daily content, and let me know in the comments so I can feature you in my next video. But coming in at number 10, now this one is basically something I should have had on my number one, because this works like a charm, and that is basically choosing one guy, now only one guy, and following him non-stop for the whole game. Now this may seem basic, but trust me, it's not this basic. Now I did this in my game a couple of nights ago, and shit was hilarious. I would keep following this one guy, and as soon as he sees me, he will run and do a circle on the map to kind of like avoid me, and that tells me that he was annoyed big time. And if you think about it, if following someone is not anything huge, like maybe you're following them to protect them and attack zombies, if you get that meme reference, you are a legend. But you always wanna follow them. And also, this is gonna like be a psychology 101 thing. What you wanna do is, when you're following them and you see them like being annoyed with you, right, you only wanna do this when they are annoyed. Don't do it before, but do this when they are annoyed. So when you see them being annoyed, basically just connect your microphone and be like, hey dude, whatever their username is, just be like, hey dude, come with me, let's kill zombies, you know, let's kill Call of Duty zombies. Say that, I swear to God, they will be annoyed. They may even rage quit, who knows, they may even rage quit, and they may even start calling you by names. But you don't wanna be triggered. Let them be triggered, and talk like a 12-year-old. If you're a 12-year-old, hey, just be you. Because when I was 12 years old, I would always do this, and dude, I had like so many good memories, and trust me, when you grow old, you're gonna look back and be like, hey, that was me, right? And also, real quick, shout out to my boy Gabe. He actually surpassed round 43 on the Giant, and I feel like it was yesterday when your boy Skizzle surpassed round 10, and I was like on the moon. And his father is a viewer of my channel, and his son is a viewer of my channel as well. So if you're watching, if you're listening, hey. But coming in at number 9, now this is all about stealing kills on the first couple of rounds. Now if you're thinking like, okay, so killing or stealing someone kills is basically so basic, I do this all the time, it's not even fun anymore, but listen, I will 10x this right now. And I'm not talking about just going to windows and trying to kill zombies one by one. So basically what you want to do is that as soon as you spawn into the map, you want to buy RK5. And hey, if you have done all the Easter eggs, guess what, you're already gonna have that RK5. So what you want to do is, you want to go to your window and you want to kill your zombies, and please don't wait for the zombies to come out and knife them. I know when you're playing solo, that's exactly what you want to do to maximize your points and shit like that, but you want to kill your zombies so others don't kill your zombies. Like, you don't want to be a victim, that's what I'm trying to say. So kill your zombies from your window, and what you want to do is, you want to go and you want to cycle through other three players' windows. So when you go there, make sure you have your RK5 out, and what you want to do is, you want to throw a grenade. That is psychology 101. I cannot stress this enough, how annoyed these players will be. All right, so you want to throw a grenade, you want to cycle through, you want to go to the second window, throw a little grenade there as well, and you want to go to the last window, throw another grenade, and you want to cycle back, and then you want to kill zombies with the RK5, basically the leftover. If there are any left zombies, you would just want to kill them with the RK5, and trust me, by the end of it, you will have so many kills, so many points, it's not even funny. But coming in at number 8, now this one was sent in by my boy Take the Cell. I'm pretty sure he will be watching this video, but unfortunately I cannot find his comment, but I quickly want to shout him out because it's his idea. Basically he said, use the time bomb in Buried when everyone has packed punch their guns, and I want to actually 10x that. So basically the idea is, as soon as you get that time bomb, you want to place it down, and you never want to touch that shit again unless you and your teammates are on round 50, or let's say they have purchased all the perks, they have got so many points, they have actually took out so many points out of their bank account, they have pack a punch their guns, they also got the wonder weapons like the paralyzer and shit like that. And you want to do this when your teammates are having the most amount of fun. Now this is very important. You don't ever want to use the time bomb when your teammates are down. I repeat, don't use the time bomb when your teammates are down. Basically, if they are down and you use the time bomb, they will be like, okay, so our team would have been dead if my boy didn't use the time bomb. So technically, they will be like, mad props, this guy used it. So you don't want to do that. You want to use it when your teammates are having the most amount of fun. And guess what? They will be annoyed. And if they have took out a lot of money from their bank account and shit like that, and if they back out, I'm pretty damn sure there will be one guy that will back out. He will just rage quit, and that's gonna be a lot of fun. But when he rage quit, after that, he's gonna realize that he have used all his points, and shit's gonna get real. But coming in at number 7, now I'm gonna teach you a dirty little trick, and I guess this is gonna backfire on me when I'm doing an open lobby, but you know what, F it, I'll actually share a dirty little trick with you guys. Now, the thing is, whenever you see a fire cell, of course you wanna grab it, and what you wanna do is, you wanna actually stay close to the box, and this is the trick. You always wanna hold square, and guess what, you're gonna be the first guy to use that fire cell mystery box, right? But not only that, what you wanna do after, this is going to annoy them. Like, the first thing, you hitting the box, that's not really gonna annoy them, but making sure whatever you get out of the box, you don't grab it. You wanna wait for that to disappear, and when it's about to disappear, hold square and hit that box again. And in that time, I swear to God, they will be so annoyed. They will be like jumping around, and they will be thinking to themselves, should I go to the next box location or not? And if they decide to do that, of course, like, they may get one hit, but realistically, if they do that, the fire cell will be over already. But you just want to waste time. You want to do that for yourself. You want to get good guns out of the box. Of course, if you get something good out of the box, then you want to take it and you want to spin the box again. The goal is, you don't want to let your teammates hit the box, and you also want to delay the time. But coming in at number 6, this is going to be all about not opening a single damn door. You never want to open a door. Make sure you know this, that doors, they don't even exist, alright? So keep that shit in mind, that they don't exist, and now you just wanna roll. So basically what you wanna do is, you wanna knife the doors, alright? Just knife the doors. And most importantly, you wanna look the player into his eyes. If the player is like killing zombies, he's just like occupied with his window and shit like that, you wanna go to him, you wanna knife him, and when he turn around, just look him, do a teabag, knife him, jump, do whatever you wanna do, just grab their attention, just run a little bit and come back to them and do that shit again, so they know that you're telling them to follow you, if you get what I'm saying. So knife them, do all kind of stuff. If you got a mic, hey, just say, hey dude, follow me. Don't say open this door, just say follow me, I have something to show you. You wanna say, this is mental, big news, you know Scarce, I know him in real life. Just say all kind of stuff. Just say, Alex, follow me on Twitter and shit like that. Just say whatever you can possibly think of at that time, and make sure you get them to follow you. And then when you get to the door, first of all, knife the door a couple of times and say, dude, can you open this door? And you don't wanna do this to any guy, you wanna make sure you do this to the guy that has the least amount of points, alright? So let's say the door costs 750 points, and if you see a guy that has maybe like 500 points, just do that to him, and this is gonna trigger them big time. But coming in at number 5, this is gonna be all about you making sure you corner them real good. Now, for this example here, I actually chose this guy right here as my victim. Now, this is the same guy that I was following. I was making sure I stay on his face. I make sure that I annoy him real good, and at the same time, I was attempting to corner him. And I feel like this works really good on Kino and the Giant. Of course, I was playing the Giant, and I will have gameplay running in the background and everything like that. So what I would do is that I would attempt to corner him and everything like that, but of course he will break that, but he will be really annoyed. He will be knifing me, he would be jumping, he will be trying to run. Sometimes I would be able to kept him behind me and everything like that, and the show was hilarious. I had a lot of fun doing that, but he would break that, and guess what, he actually went to pack a punch his guns, and this happened twice. So first of all, what I did was, of course, I was following him, and he went to pack a punch his guns, and he went inside that pack punch. Of course, like, there's a door, and guess what, I actually stand there and I actually blocked his ass. And at first he was just like looking at me, knifing me a couple of times, but what I did wrong was that I had anywhere but here. Of course, if we were on a high round, this wouldn't be a big mistake. So what I did was that I made sure the zombie would come towards me, and as soon as they hit me, I will use anywhere but here, and they will get inside of that teleporter or that pack punch machine, and they will actually kill him. But that did not happen. So in my first attempt, I kind of like effed up, but guess what? He went to pack punch his guns for the second time later on in that same game, and I got him real good. And as you guys can see, he was knifing me, and you guys can clearly tell he was like freaking annoyed. And this time I had in plain sight. Now what I did was that like I made sure the zombie come at me, and my goal was to like make sure he goes down. I don't care if I would go down or not, but I actually pop in plain sight, and I also went down, but my goal was to get him down as well. And I made sure I keep him blocked, and I made sure he loses his perks, and of course I lost my perks as well. But the point is, I cornered him. I had 10x fun in that game. Make sure you do that. Now coming in at number 4, this is the thing you wanna do. Now first of all, if they revive you, hey, Mamacita, you always wanna revive them back whenever they go down, but choose two guys in your game. You always want to have one ally, alright? I made sure one guy in this game was my ally and everything like that. He would revive me when I would go down, and I would revive him whenever he would go down. So we kind of like a tag team, if you get what I'm saying. But that guy was not trying to do what I was doing, so I will give him that. He was trying to be a good player, but hey, I was being me, if you get what I'm saying. So whenever someone goes down, you want to try to revive them, but of course you don't want to fully revive them, and you also want to teabag the shit out of it. And if you can, use the trap in the giant and make sure they don't get you moved. Just revive them, and as soon as they are revived, they will go down again, and you just want to keep on reviving till they actually rage quit. Because the thing is, when you're reviving them, they won't be able to move, but if they actually move and they go back and they are out of that trap electricity range, then it, of course, like they won't be going down and you won't be able to revive them. So that way, of course, you'll be able to raise your reviving stats and everything like that, and shit is real fun. But coming in at number 3, this works like a charm. So what you want to do is you want to be playing King of the Totem with randoms. Now this is like on a small scale. I will have another map that I will let you know in just a little bit, but if you're playing King of the Totem, make sure the teleporter is ready and make sure you got all the points in the world. And what you want to do is you want to do a call out. Hey guys, the teleporter is ready. Come on, it's gonna be real fun. We gonna get busy tonight. Let's go pack a punch our guns. I'm gonna pack a punch my thunder gun. Even if you don't have the thunder gun, just say it for the lows. I'm pretty sure if someone has a thunder gun and you say that, they will be like, Nibba, what? But hey, just say that. I'm a pack a punch my thunder gun. I'm a pack a punch my ray gun mark II. I'm a pack a punch my trip mines. I'm a pack a punch my monkey bombs. Just do a call out. Let's go to teleport. And whenever you see someone coming, just teleport. Just teleport. Don't let them come inside that teleport. Make sure you teleport 5 seconds before they get in your teleport, just to make sure that they don't get to teleport with you, right? So that's that. But that's like on a small scale. Obviously, teleporting in King of the Totem is not a big deal. It's not like gonna consume a lot of their time. Like as soon as you come back, the teleporter is gonna cool down and you can actually relink the teleporter and everything like that. So it's not a big deal. But guess what? If you're playing Mob of the Dead, you actually make sure you have the last piece, alright? Make sure you have last piece of that plane, and you only want to build a plane when there is no one around you. And whenever there's no one around you, build that plane, jump on that plane. As soon as you're on that plane, just do a call out. Guys, my plane just took off, I'm headed to the Golden Gate Bridge, would you want to come with me? And some of them will be like, yeah, sure, let me, hold on Nibba, I'm actually coming, just wait for me, don't fly just yet. But guess what, as soon as they get to the rooftop, they will see that you have disappeared. So that's that. And also the thing about Mob of the Dead is that if you're playing with 4 players or randoms, each player can have one part. They cannot have all the parts like you can have when you're playing solo. So that's really rough. Getting everyone to get all the parts and everything like that, it's really damn rough. And of course, when you're on the Golden Gate Bridge, you can stay there for a long ass time. And of course, like, it's gonna take a while. And that is the most frustrating shit in Call of Duty Zombies, and make sure you do that big time. But coming in at number 2 spot, now this is going to be kind of like a limited thing to do in Zombies. Basically, I'm talking about that Tombstone perk that is in Transit. Of course, not many people play Transit nowadays, but if you actually decide to play with randoms and if you actually find a lobby, this is what you want to do. This works really good if you're playing with your friends and everything like that. So basically, what you want to do is you want to be the guy that explains to them how good the Tombstone perk is, and you want to tell them that buy 3 perks like Jug, Speed, Double Tap, or maybe even Stamina Up, and your 4th perk should be Tombstone. And after you buy all 4 perks with Tombstone perk, hey, go down, I will keep the last zombie alive, and as soon as you're dead, I will kill that last zombie and you'll be brought back. And then you buy other perks that you haven't bought before, and also buy Tombstone perk and grab your Tombstone. And guess what, back in the days this would give you like all the perks, and this works even better in Town, right? Like Town is a small map and it's really easy to do, so you want to make sure that you get your point across to them and make sure they understand what Tombstone perk does and everything like that. And as soon as you get them to do this, as soon as you get them to buy 3 perks and Tombstone perk as well, and as soon as they go down, you don't wanna kill the last zombie. Just make sure you got Doritos, so basically make sure you have something to eat if you're getting hungry, and make sure you keep circling around, and make sure you put a movie to watch in the background just for entertainment purpose. I don't want you guys to be like bored out of your mind when you're doing this, right? So keep that last zombie alive, make sure you just do a circle thingy, or make sure you put a rubber band on your controller and do something weird with your analog stick so your controller just do this automatically and do this on autopilot. Basically, you're gonna circle around and your teammates will be watching you like do that shit. Of course, the guy that actually went down and everything like that. So and this works really good if you're playing only with 2 people, right? Because of course, like if you're playing with like 4 people, obviously other people will kind of like kill the zombies. If they're your friends, obviously they may be just like standing still and they may not kill the last zombie. But hey, I know you get the point. But coming in at number 1, now this one is going to annoy the shit out of them. Basically, the thing is, you want to grab all the drops. Doesn't matter if it's a max ammo drop, doesn't matter if it's a nuke drop, but the point is, if you see a nuke on round 1 or round 2, or basically on early rounds, whenever you see those drops, grab them, and as soon as you grab them, just say, hey dude, I got a nuke, do you want me to grab it? Just say that after you actually grab it. And the thing is, if they are not like a newbie player, they will be like so triggered, because the thing is, if you grab the nuke, that will kill all the zombies, and they're most likely gonna want to kill zombies, right? Obviously, they want points, they want more kills, and they wanna like hit the mystery box, they wanna buy perks and shit like that. But you wanna grab the nuke and you wanna do this to them, and I swear to God, this works like a charm. Psychology 101, I know all of it. Yeah, I know this. This is gonna annoy them real good. But anyways guys, thank you all so much for watching. Let me know in the comment section right now what would be that one thing that you would do to randoms, and hey, I may feature in the next video. And also, check out some other videos on the screen if you have missed any of them. Subscribe if you happen to be new, and smash that like button if you did enjoy this video, and I'll see you very freaking soon.